86. Now, forecast for tonight, still a threat off to our west of a shower, maybe an isolated thunderstorm, mild temperatures, but it will stay dry in Savannah. Looking at tomorrow, this front just does not progress down through our area. Instead, we'll keep more of a southerly breeze going. That means a hot day with highs around 90, and a few locations will be above 90. And we've really dried out here the last 3 weeks, less than a tenth of an inch of rain. In Savannah, you go back to the 1st of March, and our deficit continues to swell. That is now over 3 inches. As a result, the updated drought monitor that came out today, we're in this tan and yellow color here across much of our area. And that means we are anywhere from abnormally dry to moderate drought conditions. And then you go down to parts of Pearson, Wayne counties, down into the Panhandle and North Florida. Those areas have severe drought conditions. We need some rain across our area, and Friday will not be the day that we see that. Low 90s from Vidalia through Elma, Blackshear, and Jessup. And this will be a common theme here the next couple days. Upper 80s to low 90s. 90 in Darien. We go to the northwest in Statesboro tomorrow. 92 degrees. 91 in Springfield to end the work week. And we'll have mostly to partly sunny skies in Savannah. 91 out on the islands. 84 in Tybee before the sea breeze kicks in. Same for Hilton Head, Ridgeland, and Hampton. In the low 90s for Friday's forecast. How about the weekend? Upper 80s, near 90 degrees, very little change through Sunday. And then Monday's forecast, we'll see a front enter the picture. Could be some showers and storms with highs about 80 to 85 early in the week. We'll jump up a little bit Wednesday, and then we start to cool things back. And if we added an eighth or ninth day to the forecast, we may be talking about highs back to the 70s.